Today we are going to concentrate on the frame surrounding the Odroid 3 Plus, its power switch and fan mounting, plus the front grille. One of the bonuses of using MakerBeam is that the beams do have a very useful groove, which lends itself to holding in place the front or sides of your case. These can be perforated aluminium, laser cut acrylic, or in this case, perforated polypropylene. This can be cut with wire snips or shears, and evened off with a Dremel. The power switch on the motherboard is at the back, and not easy to access when the Odroid is in a case or frame. However, there are pins on the GPIO that can be used to attach a power switch. Odroid also supply a really good, fully wired up power switch. So connecting the external power switch is very straightforward, as the wires are long enough to accommodate the majority of small cases. I've now added to the MakerBeam frame to allow the front grills to be slid in and to give more rigidity to the whole frame. I've increased the height of the standoffs to raise the Odroid up slightly to allow additional ventilation underneath the motherboard. I've also mounted the fan initially immediately behind the Odroid, allowing it to be slid back or forward depending on how much cooling is required. This horizontal beam is fastened to the base using corner cubes by using a small machined nut shaped to the groove in the MakerBeam strut. This allows the bolt to be loosened off to slide the horizontal beam back and forward so you may get the optimal position for the fan. At the moment, I'm still powering this Odroid H3 Plus using the Odroid supplied power supply. I plan on fitting three Odroids eventually to this frame and powering them all from one HDPlex 400 watt power supply. However, the work on this first H3 Plus is just about completed. The next Odroid in the frame is going to have two SATA connected discs in addition to the M2 fitted SSD. However, that will have to wait until the next video. That's it for today. Thank you for watching.